Good morning, children. Welcome back to English class. In previous class, we have completed the grammar topic subject. Isn't it, children? Subject, and you wrote some sentences and you identified the subject in the sentence. And today, we are going with the another part of the sentence, that is predicate. What is it? Predicate. P-R-E-D-I-C-A-T-E. Predicate. Okay, see children, in 5.7, read this sentence. The dogs chased the jackal. What did the dogs do in this sentence? Okay, the dogs chased the jackal. What did the dogs do? Dogs aim chesai? Chased the jackal. The predicate tells us something more about the subject. What the subject does or describes it in some way. What the predicate will tell children? See, the first part, usually the front part, the starting of the sentence, what it will be? It will be subject, and remaining part will be predicate. And in that predicate, what we will see, children? What the subject do? What the subject does in that sentence? Subject aim chestundi, deni kosam cheptundi, or describes, okay, what it does. That part can be called as predicate. Okay, see, the dogs chased the jackal. The dogs chased the jackal. In this sentence, the dogs is the subject of the sentence, right, children? Because who chased the jackal? The dogs. Who chased the dog jackal? The dog. The rest of the sentence tells us what they did to the jackal. What these dogs did to the jackal is telling remaining part of the sentence. Right, children? Hence, the predicate is chased the jackal. What is the predicate in the sentence? Chased the jackal. The predicate always includes a verb and usually starts with it. Okay, verb in this sentence, what is the verb, children? Tell me. Yes, chased. What is the verb in this sentence? Chased. Chased means, okay, chasing, and it is an action word. That's why it's become a verb. The predicate always involves, eppudu predicate lo verb untundi, and usually ante ekku satham predicate verb tho start avutundi. Remember that thing, children. Okay, always the predicate includes verb and it's usually start with it. Okay, the remaining part of the predicate may consists of noun, adjective, article, preposition, and adverb. That means a verb is there, and remaining part may be a verb or a noun or an adverb. Okay, verb will not be, already verb completed, right? Then noun, adjective, or article, or a preposition, or an adverb may come in the remaining part of the predicate. But remember one thing, the sentence will be start with, mostly will start with the subject, and remaining part, what the subject is doing and for what the subject is describing, that part can be called as predicate. And this part includes what? Verb. What it include? Verb. And usually it starts with it. That means here the predicate starts with the verb, children. Now see, all the sentences will have the subject, children. Do all the sentences will have the subject? Let's see. Clean your room. Stand at the door. Is these two sentences are having subject or not? Subject and predicate is there. Let's check it. Some, command, order, an order, will not have the subject in the sentence. Command means close the door or shut your mouth. Okay, like this commands or order. Okay, like this orders will not, normally the subject will not mention in that sentence. Okay, subject will be there, but we will not mention in the sentence. Then how we will know what is the subject in that sentence? Yes, see, do it now. Do it now. To whom I'm talking? To whom I'm talking? I'm talking to you. I'm talking to you. That means here the subject will be you. Y-O-U. Okay, you do it now. Okay, I'm skipping you and I'm asking, do it now. In short form, I'm saying. Right, children? Like that. Stay inside. Stay inside. I am talking to you and I'm saying that stay inside. You stay inside. Who will stay inside? You. That means the subject is you. Actually, we have to understand that this you will become, it will comes before do and it comes before stay. Okay, you do it now, you stay inside. Like that we have to think for few sentences. Those are command or an order, like that. Okay, now turn your pages, children. Now see here, this is the explanation more about this predicate and subject. This is subject and this is predicate. This side is predicate and this side is subject. See, subject names the person, thing spoken about, and predicate says something about the subject, isn't it? And next, subject noun or a pronoun, and predicate will be verb. Subject beginning of a sentence, subject where it will be beginning of the sentence, and predicate follows the subject. That means after the subject, predicate will come. Subject is a noun, predicate begins with a verb. Okay, children, is it clear for you? Okay, now see in companion, children, already 5A we have completed in companion. Now see 5B, page number 33. See what is it in it. Read the following sentences, circle the subject and underline the predicate. One is done for you. What you have to do, children? You have to circle the subject of the sentence and underline the predicate in the sentence. See, one they have did. The small squirrel ran across the yard. Who ran across the yard? The small squirrel. Okay, the answer is the small squirrel. That means it is the subject. And from here, ran, from the verb, the remaining part is predicate. Remember that all predicate. Predicate will start with verb. Okay? And if you ask a question to that sentence, you will get the answer. That answer can be subject for that sentence. Like that you have to circle the subjects and underline the predicate for these following sentences, children. Okay, do this one as homework. Okay, and we will go with the textual exercises, remaining textual exercises, in our next class. Okay, children, thank you so much. Have a nice day.